Frank, you know, we've talked also, if I can talk about something for a minute here, we've talked a lot on the show about gun violence and violence in the United States, and, you know, that's definitely been one of the big issues under the Trump administration, as all the other presidents. And we had another incident here in Toronto last week where on Thursday at about 6 p.m., someone was shot and killed, and it happened to be a very, very close friend of mine, John Gayle, who worked with me at TSN and Sportsnet, worked in the media for a number of years, and it was one of the toughest things I've ever had to deal with, and it brought me back to something we've talked about on this show.
I'm sorry, I didn't follow that story. Where was he shot and killed?
So Thursday at 6 o'clock last week, actually it was on Wednesday. Wednesday, John and I, we do a football podcast together. And we had finished filming at 3 o'clock, and he was murdered 3 hours later in Etobicoke. He was shot and killed in his car and was pronounced dead immediately after the car hit a tree after he was shot. So another case of senseless gun violence. And this time, it just unfortunately for me came very close to home, as it happened to one of my good friends.
Is there any reason why he was targeted to be murdered? Was he targeted to be murdered?
We believe so, and there's still a pending investigation, but nothing has been founded yet.
Yeah, but
what would prompt?
I'm trying to say is
it sounds random, right?
What time was this done, in broad daylight?
So this happened at 6 o'clock in the evening.
So at 6 o'clock in the evening, he went home, or he was parked at the light?
He was on his way. He was driving in Etobicoke, and he was shot. And he was dead immediately in the car, went into a tree. And shockingly, at 6 o'clock, there were no witnesses. There's no video footage. There's a pending investigation. I know the cops are still asking for anyone who has any information on what happened to please come forward. A few of my friends have come forward with the information that they know about what possible reasons could have been for him being targeted. But
what was the possible reason?
Well, could have been mixed up with a girl, a jealous ex. That was one of the theories that I had heard. That was what a friend of mine had told the police, and they're still working on the investigation. So, very tragic thing, and we've talked so often on this show about how easy it is to get guns and how easy it is to go and sense
the speed. I don't know if it was in the Toronto Star. I read that the big business now, and the police just raided a few areas in the greater GTA, is that you can buy legally in Ontario parts for guns, you know, and they buy all these parts and they put them together and they sell these guns.
Yeah.
They don't have to go import them and go through the dangers of getting caught at the border. Like, that's a little fucking stupid, isn't it?
I know. It's incredibly stupid how easy it is for anyone to get something like that and be able to do something like this. I mean,
yeah, so smart criminals buy all of this stuff, and legally, they buy it legally, and they put the guns together and they sell them.
The question is, how do you stop that, though, right?
Exactly.
How do you stop that?
Well,
killing nuts.
Simple.
You can't buy nuts.
Guys, are you guys fine? Look, it is illegal to buy a handgun or a concealed weapon without, you know, doing... And you can have a concealed weapon here, but you can buy parts with no registration. It's easy to fix. Anytime anybody buys a gun part, it has to be registered.
Exactly.
You have to have ID and all of that. That's it.
But what constitutes a gun part? I guess it's like, I guess it's
every
you're
part.
Building the barrel, you're building the handle. That's pretty obvious, I guess, yeah.
You can buy online, apparently, from the column that I read.
Mm-hmm.
Every part of a gun and put it together. So these criminals...
you'd buy it from the state, have it shipped across and shipped over, and then you'd build it here?
No. In Ontario, there's actual wholesalers, this thing, where you can go buy all the parts for a gun. So you buy all these parts from, let's say, 30 suppliers, right? And you're putting the guns together and selling them here in Ontario. You don't have to...
Yeah.
go over the border. You don't have to be, you know, you don't have to get mules. You don't have to be scared. You know what I'm saying?
Right. That's creepy. Yeah. Yeah, it's, you know, like we've talked about, you know, how this is such a problem in the States. And then when you see something like this happen to a friend in Canada and you read, like, it's the 96th time or something that this has happened this year. It's really, really alarming. And you want to come up with ways to prevent it, to stop it from happening, but it just keeps happening over and over again.
This is the worst year for Toronto, for gun violence.
But it's still like 1/50th or 1/100th of what they have in Chicago.
It doesn't matter. That's comforting. That's not a comfort, and that's not rationale. I'm telling you that it is, this is under John Tory's watch. It has become, even if it ends up in 100 murders in 1 year in a city that's basically the same size as Chicago, you know, the criminologists will say that's pretty good for that amount of population per capita for that statistic. I say no. We're used to being a very safe. Look, all countries in the world, Italy, England, Australia, Germany, Spain, you're not allowed to have guns.
Yeah.
The United States is the only country that has this.
Well, you know, in a perfect example of deflection, Trump banned bump stocks today. Did you see that?
You what?
He banned bump stocks.
Yeah, it took him, what the fuck did it take?
You know what that was? It's deflection from the shit that's going on with Flint. That's what all it is.
Yeah, but that guy, the guy in Las Vegas, who converted that gun into basically a machine gun.
Into a semi-automatic or whatever with the bump stock, yeah.
That was over a year ago.